Hi everybody, today I do my second voiceover because the first one didn't work because my microphone had some issues or problems. So yes, I'm so happy to talk every English stuff again because my English is so great. I love to talk everything twice or say everything twice. So yes, today it's about not only stenciling, it's also about adding some fineliner to your stencil. It's not such a difficult technique, so it's not a video how you it's not a video for learning how to do, but maybe watching this video and my three cards is kind of inspiring you, that you have any ideas what you can do with your stencils and which stencils maybe are better for this technique. So yes, I'm started with the first card. The first card is nearly ready now. And I used this stencil. I have no idea. I thought it was a Create a Smile stencil, but it isn't. And I have no idea where it is from. But I think many companies have stencils like this. And yes, I need to say it's also my favorite card. The first cards I like, I like more than the cards at the end. And yes, I added some greens, two green tones. And for a special interest, I think instead of maybe sequins or nouveau drops or things like that, I just added my fineliner to this stencil. I tried it on a card before this week, some days ago, and because I had such a tiny image and so such a huge background, so yes, I thought this background was a little bit naked, so that is why I tried out this fineliner into the stencil, and I thought it's a good idea to show this in the today's video for you. So this card, yes, just missing some sentiments, and these sayings are from a German set, but this is also available in English. It's a set full of things like shit happens, and if you need to, what is the word? I googled it up. It's swearing when you say bad words. Is it swearing? And the sentiment means such a shit. But maybe swearing helps. So yeah, I think in times of Corona, I mix up the German words. In times of Corona, cards like this, yes, helps to stay in contact, to make the people laugh or your friends laugh. And yeah, so that is why I choose this sentiment. Now we are into card number two. This little mouse, our super mouse, is from a stamp set. It's the most of the stamp sets from Create a Smile are available in German and English. I have the German version, but the mouse is in both sets the same, of course. And yes, I colored it with my, oh yes, the stamp set name is Superpower. In German, it's Superkräfte, if you like to learn some German. Yes, and this little mouse is a super mouse, and that is why it has a cape. And yes, I colored the cape red because the most superheroes I know, I think, maybe, does have a red cape. And also this red color, I think, matches perfect to the blue sky I will do later or after coloring. And the most of the times I color is in two layers. And in my second layer, as you can see me doing now, I start with a darker tone than in my first layer. So in this case, it's a great hint I got from Christina from Create a Smile. The V99 is it's not a red, but it's such a great dark color you can use for your red shading in the darkest corners. So yes, just adding some white gel pen, and this is my cute little mouse. Yay! Now I'm using this cloud stencil. I think the name is Cloudy Pattern. You find it all in the Create a Smile shop. Under this video, I will link you the stencil section from Create a Smile, so you can see all these beauties. Yes, and I'm just using again my Distress Oxides and my favorite brush. And at the end, I thought, yes, on the top right corner, there's a cloud, there's a little hole or a free spot. So I added just a little extra cloud. After cleaning the stencil, just a little hint for you. When you clean your stencils, make sure that you do not change the sides, the front and the back. So if you want to line up your stencil again, maybe, okay, in this clouds, it's not so difficult. But when you have a crazy pattern, sometimes you have some struggles to find the right position of your stencil. So keep this in your mind when you clean up your stencil. So, and again, I use my fineliner. I hope fineliner is also an English word because it sounds so English. And on, like I did it on all my cards, I do not line up all the clouds completely. So only some little parts. And I also took one longer line and some short lines, like stitchy line. And yes, on this card, I wished I would have think about the sentiment before. So then I would have left an empty spot for this. I'm not happy with stamping all over this clouds. And but my problem was I also didn't want to stamp on over these black lines. But I find a free spot. But now I need to put the sentiment there and was not free to choose a place. So, but at the end, it's okay. Now I need to find the right position for this little mouse. It was a little bit difficult for me. Normally, I put it on and it's ready. But here I needed some seconds to think about it. But finally, the mouse got his place. So as you can see, I used a dirty cardstock. But yeah, it's not for the trash, because when you can hide it, then you can use it. Oh, it sounds like a slogan. If you can hide it, you can use it. So this was the second card, and now we come to the last one. It's about this little froggy. I colored it with green, and since some month, I had this new technique, not kind of technique. I struggled for a long time finding good copy combination or remembering these copy combination for the next time. I didn't want it to put it on a or noticed on a paper and look for the paper every time. So I started to put all my favorite combinations or all the combinations I'm finding while I'm coloring. I put together with a kind of, wait, I looked for the word, rubber band. From I normally use them in the kitchen. And so I have a lot of rubber bands now in my at my crafting desk. And at the end of the coloring, you see for a second my copy bundle. But I like this. It's so easy. I just pull out the bunch of copics, and I do not need to search for the numbers or search for what is matching. Yeah, and now the coloring is over, and I come to the last stencil. I forgot the name, but you find it. There are not thousands of stencils, but a lot, and a lot of beautiful stencils. And yes, and this one again, I color in with two colors. And this time, or in this case, I'm using these good old normal distress inks because I have no oxide in a really good red. But it's on the list. I will buy it in the next Corona month. Yes, and I added also orange. And these colors are, wait, carved pumpkin and candied apple. I hope I pronounce it right. And then again, I clean up my stencil, and I took my fine liner, or my liner, fine, whatever. And again, I didn't lined in, colored in all the stencil, but maybe it's okay. Maybe you can use it some millimeters next to the original colors, I think this is also a great effect. And somehow I have some problems with this card. I don't know why. Maybe it's the color of the frog or the color of this orange sentiment. But I do not like it so much. I love these color drops. I think this gives some more interest to the card, and it's not so naked anymore. But when I'm putting the frog back to this place, I do not like the card as much as I like the card without the frog. I don't know why. Maybe you have some answers of this for this question. So, yes, but we're near to the end of the video. Yes, I know I should have used my heating tool for drying these water drops, but I had some luck and I didn't ruin the card because I was very careful. So now I around the corners from this card. I think very clean cards. They got more special with rounded corners. So now we are near to the end. Yeah, I hope my microphone was great this time. These are all my cards. I hope you liked my little technique. It's just a little trick you can use on your cards. Yes, nice weekend. Bye bye.